There's no way about it. 2020 has been a big year. We're still working our way through the pandemic. The government put the country into lockdown. We've had numerous leadership challenges, scandals and leaks in the National Party, and an election that saw Labor win by a historic landslide. So what can we expect next year? For more, we're joined by One News political editor Jessica Mutch McKay. Morena, Jess.
Morena, Jenny May.
Okay, what a year. I mean, we had pretty much everything, didn't we? But let's talk about the winners, and we've decided we're not going to use the word losers this morning. We're going to go winners and non-winners. But those columns pretty much pick themselves, don't they? I mean, on the winner's side, you've got Labor, you've got ACT, and on the losers, non-winner's side, you've got National and probably Winston Peters, I'm guessing.
There you go. So you don't really need me. You've got it.
Give us all the info, Jess. Winners
and losers
for you.
I mean, the winners this year, I think, have been very obvious. Labor had the mandate to govern alone, which is an extraordinary outcome. So we've got that. Jacinda Ardern has been internationally praised for her handling of the health response of COVID-19. So those are, I think those are in the winners' camp. In the non-winners camp, I'm reasonably comfortable with calling the term losers, but we'll go with non-winners.
You go with whatever you want to go with,
yeah,
Jess.
We'll go with the losers' camp. You've got New Zealand First and Winston Peters struggled to get back in, didn't have a good year, probably should have handled the campaign in a different way, probably should have played up their relationship with Labor rather than doing the traditional thing of saying, no, we're going to keep hold them to account and do it differently. So, and he's a big loss. New Zealand First, Winston Peters not making it back. You'd have to say the National Party, a really bad result at the election. Also, we had all of this COVID stuff play out, and then suddenly in the mix of it, politics thought, oh, hang on a second, we'll have a couple of leadership changes just to throw into the mix as well. So they really struggled this year. Oh, but I forgot ACT. ACT also in the winners' camp as well. Extraordinary, increasing tenfold the number of MPs in Parliament.
Yeah, David Seymour and nine of his mates in Parliament. So let's look back at the last 3 years, at the last government, Labor, New Zealand First, Greens coalition government. There's been a fair amount of criticism about the promise to be transformational. Have they, Jess? What could they have done better?
You're right, they did play up this whole idea of being transformational, and there were lots of so-called handbrakes along the way that they weren't able to do the things that they wanted to do. The thing is now is they can be transformational, so let's see if they're going to be. I think there's a lot of expectation on the Prime Minister to do the things that she laid out when, I guess, she gave people hope and people really turned to her, and now she's got the chance to do it. So I do think that 2021 is going to be a big year for that. That they can do whatever they want in Parliament, which is an extraordinary position to be in. We haven't had that under an MMP government. They don't even need the support of the Greens. They'd like it, but they don't need it to make these big changes. So they do get to go away over the Christmas break and say, right, what are our priorities? Let's do this, this and this.
What were the main turning points or main moments, biggest moments for you this year, Jess?
I think there are a couple of big moments. I think for me, and we've actually just done our year in review wraps for viewers at home, we kind of sit down and go through all the library footage and go through all the stories. And I was looking at a live that I did in the middle of March, and it was when the Prime Minister announced she was closing the borders, and it was a Saturday afternoon. And I remember standing there doing the live cross thinking, I'm about to tell New Zealand that the borders are closing. And I just found it one of those moments I couldn't quite wrap my head around it, that we're about to say it's not just China and Iran that we're closing ourselves off to, we are closing our borders. And you almost, it's one of those things that you're like, I just want to check that I'm right, just making sure I've got this right. We are effectively closing our borders. And I think that was one of those moments that I think for me, I knew things were about to be really different. I also think going into the lockdown, when we went into level 4 lockdown, I was sitting, I'd come in after doing the 1 o'clock update, I'd come in and I was sitting almost in the front row at the Prime Minister's press conference. So I was kind of looking up at her like that. And she delivered the news that we were going into lockdown, that this was, we were going to go home and stay home. And I remember thinking, oh, this is a big, big moment as well. So I think often in journalism, you don't realise the big moments until later. You don't process them till later. But this year, I've definitely processed a few at the time.
Well, it's been a big year, Jess. Are you going to have a bit of a break now?
I am.
Great.
I am.
Yeah, you deserve it. It's been one heck of a year, and you've done some amazing work this year, and we appreciate you getting up early and being with us here on Breakfast. So thank you so much.
Got a bit of a dream team, so I'm pretty lucky in the press gallery.
Yeah, beautiful, Jess. Have a good break, and thank you once again.
You too, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jess.